My name is Guillermo Munro Colosio, and Memuco comes from basically that name. I was born in LA, and then I was raised in Mexico. Moved to Mexico, northern Mexico, when I was about 6 years old, and grew up there until I was about 16. And then after that, I was basically back and forth between the US and Mexico most of the time. There was this like a course or this guy from National Geographic was coming over to China, to Xi'an, and he was giving, you know, a talk on infographics. So I came over and I said, well, I'm gonna know if I like, you know, if I like it or whether or not. So I came first to that. But when I was in Xi'an, I really loved it. Even though like a lot of people say, oh, Xi'an, there's nothing happening. To me, it was like, ah, it's cool. And I would be like, you know, having my beer, and then people would come like, hey, and they would like, you know, kanpai and all that stuff. And I was like, you have to love a place like that, right? It's like, how can you not live here? And I was like, yeah, I'll live here, no problem. My daily work consists of doing infographics and illustrations for newspapers or magazines, depends. But most of the jobs that I've had are for newspapers. So this goes hand in hand with paintings also. Like when I do a painting, at the same time, I try to have a graphic. So because when I have the painting up in the show, it's a little bit of information and education and reinforcing a lot of stuff that, you know, we know, but we don't, sometimes we forget. When I went to school, I remember doing drawings, but I don't remember the classes very well. And most of my time has been like spent on drawing and daydream. Basically, I lived in a daydream most of the waking hours. So I don't know if you say imaginative or something, but yeah, everything was alive, or you could make anything come to life and just draw it. And in Mexico, we have this character called Katrina, which is the Lady of Death. She's a very elegant woman. She's all skeleton. And so I invented this story that she's the daughter of the Katrina, and the dad is this Nahual, which is like this, in ancient Mexico, is like this being that has the power to convert himself into any animal he wants. So she has the blood of animals, and she's also like the daughter of death. So she grows up and she likes the animals and all that. And then one day the mom says, well, it's time for you to get to work because you're, you know, you're my daughter. So you're gonna go around the world and take endangered species and put them to sleep. So because she is also like, you know, part of her is animal and all that stuff. She really goes into pain. It's really painful for her to do this, you know, every time. And she gets angry. She gets frustrated with her mom, with the world, with the, you know, with human beings and. Because they're like these crimes that are being done against animals, the poaching especially. So basically that's what it is. Like she goes around the world, takes animals, but it's like this big dilemma, this big contrast of feelings and that she has to face every day, or, you know. So this would be the newest one. And this one I did for an LA show. This one I did last year in Mexico before coming here back. I think so my colors changed a lot here. Before, my colors would, I think Chicago was kind of like cobalt blue, and I still use them. But now I see that my paintings are evolving into, I didn't use yellow that much before, or red or orange. And now my paintings are full of yellow, full of red, and full of orange. And definitely it has to do with being here, yeah. I cannot pinpoint how it happened or when it happened. And there's a lot of gray also, and I don't know if that's because of the city, Beijing. I'm saying gray because the city itself, like if you go to a hutong, that's the official color of the hutongs, right? It's not because, oh my God, it's gray all the time, which sometimes you feel like it is. But I definitely like, it has had some kind of effect on me. And each city has that effect. Where you live, definitely. it's been an amazing experience. Yeah, and it's been, there's much more that I take, and I hope that there's a lot that I have given also, or I want to still, you know, still give. But there's a lot more that I take and that this country has given me, I think, by being here than anything else, than in most countries that I've been, I think, yeah. So it's been an amazing experience, yeah.